There's a lot of money to be made in wholesaling real estate. Today, I'm going to share with you a 5-point formula that you can implement to make sure that you're not spending your money where it doesn't need to be spent, making sure that you can grow and scale your real estate investing business. Coming right up. Hey, this is Jamel Gibbs with the REI Education Academy, helping you close deals consistently in your real estate investment business. And on this channel, what we do are real estate investing how-to videos and tutorials, as well as videos of me actually doing and investing in real estate. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And at any point in the video, if I mention any resources, those resources will be linked in the description box below in case you want to get started with them right away. So let's go ahead and jump right in. All right, so today I'm going to share with you a 5-point profit system that you can implement right into your wholesaling business in order to operate your business the right way. Make sure you have enough money for your business. Make sure you can market your business, have enough money for team and overhead. Make sure you have enough savings and enough profit for your business and for your pockets as well. So those 5 points that we're going to talk about today are: number one, profit; number two, savings; number three, marketing; number four, overhead and team; and number five, taxes. So be sure to implement exactly what I'm going to share with you today, because it will help you in growing and scaling your wholesaling business from nothing to whatever you want it to be. All right, so first and foremost, what I personally like to do is take out 20% of anything that comes into the company for the entire month for profit, and I pay myself first. The reason why you want to take 20% is primarily because you will have enough money to be able to live off of as well as operate your business the right way. So I personally like to take 20%. So just to give you an example, if we make $100,000 for the month, I'm taking $20,000 and I'm paying that to myself first. Second, what I like to do is I like to take 10% for savings. So just to give you an example, if we do, let's say, $100,000 for the month, I'm gonna take $10,000 in profit for savings for the entire business. Now, that savings can be held in a business savings account, or it can be held in your personal account. It can go towards your personal savings as well. That's entirely up to you. But you wanna take 20% for profit, and that's for your personal living expenses. And then you wanna take 10% for savings for your business or for your personal savings as well. Personally, what I would do is I would take 20%. I would take a portion of that 20% and I would apply that towards personal savings. And I would use the 10% from the business as business savings. And that way you always have some money for your business in case things go sour. Third, you want to apply marketing. You want to have enough money for marketing in your business. So how much money do you want to take for marketing? What I personally do is I take 20% of my profit for marketing. So again, using $100,000 as an example, what we do is we'll take 20% of $100,000, and that allows us to have enough money for postcard mailings and ringless voicemail and, you know, cold callers and things like that. That allows us to have enough money for lead generation for our business. So what I would do, if you, let's say you make $10,000 a month, you can take $2,000 and apply that back towards your business so that you can continue to generate leads in your business. Now, once you're generating leads, you also need a team, right? So what we do is we take 20% of the income that comes in for the month for a team and overhead. And this ensures that we have enough money to pay our team members. So whether we have virtual assistants, we have local individuals who are looking at houses and helping us operate our business, we pay them from that 20% so that we can continue to grow and scale our business. And as our profits scale, guess what happens? We hire more people because we have more money to hire on because of that 20% as well. Finally, you want to take out 30% for taxes. Now, the taxes can fluctuate. The more money you make, obviously, the more money you're going to pay in taxes. But you can also write off a lot of things. Now, as I've mentioned before, I'm not an accountant, I'm not an attorney, I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just telling you exactly what works for us and our business. Just to recap exactly what I just said, we take 20% out for profits, We take 10% out for savings. We take 20% out for marketing. We take 20% out for team and overhead. And then we take another 20% out, a 30% out for taxes. All right. And by you taking out all of this, you'll see that it equates to 100% of the profits that go into your business. Now, on a smaller scale, if you run a business and you're only making, let's say, $10,000 a month, most people, what they're going to do is they're going to go out and spend that money on nonsense. Okay. A lot of people forget to take out money for taxes. A lot of people don't reinvest into their business. I'm encouraging you to utilize this formula. It works for me. I've been doing this for 18 years, and I'm sure it can work for you as well. So again, 20% for profit, 10% for savings, 20% for marketing, 20% for team and overhead, 30% for taxes. And if you implement that formula, you'll be well on your way to growing a very successful wholesaling business. Hope you guys enjoyed today's training. Be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell as well. And also leave a comment below. Let me know what you're doing in your business. If you're actively wholesaling, let me know what you're doing in order to make sure that you operate your business the right way. Make sure that you have enough money for your business and how much you're paying yourself from your business as well.